Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred and I left some tape on my table, on my desk, a couple of things that I was working on because yesterday I was talking about unboxing the package that I got, the latest Flow magazine with its poster book. So, and I think the day before, I'm not sure anymore, sorry, I was talking about opening the envelope. Well, that was not the envelope, but a bubble wrap envelope with the washi tape things that I bought at the Coffee Monsters Co. And this is actually my snack. Not actually the sausage here. These two were actually from this morning. I made breakfast. Whole wheat slices bread with slices of these sausages, and I sliced two slices of sausage too much, and I thought by myself, well, I'll leave it on the kitchen. So then a couple of hours later I was a bit peckish, and I went to my mom and dad's house. Well, there was stairs between us, because he asked me, like, Millie, come and get fresh fish. Your mom bought some fish. And I was thinking about, I didn't know what to do yesterday for dinner. And I was happy she bought fish, for that was going to be our dinner. Steamed Chinese fish with, I forgot to make picture of that. Oh no, that's stupid. Well, it was delicious, the fish. My children had not have actual fresh fish over a year. We had fish, well, that was frozen fish. I'm sorry. So these two slices were actually raw, but because I had to microwave the bits on the little saucer, I think I overdid it. I think I did it like 1 minute, and this dark sausage popped a little bit out of its casing, as you can see. This is a real Suriname snack for us. You know what? I'm gonna eat my slices of sausage, because it's hard to point at something when it's in the way. So I'm gonna eat the sausage first. Sorry. So now I can point better. So in Suriname, they make sausages, and then they have a very large soup pan filled with water and parsley, bit salt, I think that's it. And then they put a lot of sausages in its casing hole, like we call this is bloodworst. So this is blood sausage. Oh yes, sorry, disclaimer. If you're vegan or vegetarian, skip, I think, 10 minutes forward, or less than 10 minutes, 5 minutes forward. So this is blood sausage, bloodwurst. This is fleischwurst, that is meat sausage. And this is bere, that is the inside casing of your... No, not... Not yours, of a animal colon, I believe it, that's it. Then you get, I'm not sure, well, maybe, I'm sorry, I haven't had this for a long time. I always eat the meat sausage and the blood sausage. So you're gonna say, that's weird, blood sausage, normally it's fluid, how come it's solid like this? You see, I prick, the whole sausage move. It's solid because They mix the blood, pig's blood, with bread. Bread, how do you call it? Bread, snippings, bread, crumbles. Yeah, that's it. And this is a little sauce. We have, even in Dutch and in Suriname, now I've forgotten the name. Shoot. I just remembered the name. Now I've forgotten it. It's not mustard. It's a little bit of mustard and a bit, little bit of vegetable bits. Well, I'm gonna put it in the description, or maybe it will pop up in my head. Shoot. It's on the tip of my tongue, but it's not appearing the whole name. No, it won't come up. So, the blood sausage and the meat sausage, you don't eat with the sauce. It's only with this bere. You just dip it into the sauce and then eat it. So, we don't eat it cold. That's why it's in a big pot of boiled water. So you go to the stand, and this man behind the stand, he asks you how much you want to have. Just one sausage piece, bloedworst or vleeswurst, or you want a plastic box of the amount of €5 or €10 or up. But, and if you he'll ask you what would you like to have in it, you'll say mix, so that's mix, and he'll say mix what, because it most of people eat these too. They don't like this because people don't like offal. So you have to specify, I want all, that means the bere also. But most of people, they'll choose, when they say mix, the meat sausage and the blood sausage. So this is from yesterday. Yesterday. My dad picked it up in our street, the main street where we live. There's a tattoo shop. The tattoo shop is gone because of COVID. Last year, he was not allowed to have customers, and this year also not. So he decided, I think last year, I don't know, was it 6 months ago, the tattoo shop stopped opening its doors. But next to the tattoo shop, it was a cafe. And you know, when you have beer and alcoholic beverages, he started to sell this. And I saw that also yesterday when I was doing grocery shopping. I needed to have vegetables, so I went to a Turkish supermarket to get pak choi. Yeah, that's weird. Chinese vegetables at the Turkish grocery store. If you walked further from the Turkish supermarket, you walk further to Orkida, well, not sponsored, that's the name of the supermarket. There was a tandoori shop that's new. I think it was 2019 it opened its door, this tandoori shop, or was it 2020? I don't know anymore. I walked past by and I saw in its window, he has no window shopping or something, but suddenly he created in his window shelves, wooden shelves, and on each shelf there was different kinds of bread. I'm like, what? You're a tandoori shop and suddenly you sell bread and croissants and we have a word for this. I don't know how to say it in English. When there is special bread that is made by, call it specialty bread. I don't know how to explain it in English. But I saw that some of these winkels, winkel is in Dutch for stores. I saw some of the stores that is originally selling stuff is now in pandemic time selling other stuff. I'm like, what's going on here? Well, you probably noticed by now that I haven't been for a while outside. So, yeah, I like to smother the berry in a lot of sauce. So that's weird. I forgot the sauce name. I don't like all offal. I like some, but not all. This is okay. But some people are like squeamish about offal. So this is the back side of the sausage. We call it kontje. Kontje, we call it also at when you have a whole loaf of bread and then the outer side piece, we call it the bum, or how do you say it? Yeah, I know, it's weird to translate something Dutch into English. And yeah, I call this the kontje. I normally don't eat it with sauce, but we have so much sauce, I'm gonna smother it in it. We don't eat the casing. We chew on it and we throw it away. I was planning to do something today, but I don't think I have enough time for that. So apparently, I think it's best you don't watch this vlog anyways, if you don't like to see offal. This is the best. I will leave that for later. I don't eat it with sauce. The sauce? Wow. Because there's a little bit sauce left. There's a lot of heat in it. It's so peppery. The top part wasn't that peppery, but now we reached almost the bottom. That's so hot. Wow. Okay, what I was planning to do, because today is officially spring, well, according to the Western world, I was planning to open this and to break it out of its box and then assemble it. But now I think, let's see how far I'll go. I'm not sure. I hope it will happen fast. So let's still try it. I'm gonna eat this.
So good.
I haven't had bloedworst for a year and 3 months, I think. Well, more than even. This one I have. It's in that corner. But this one is hard to get at the official Lego store or anywhere. And I think they had they failed Lego, because at the time that was Chinese New Year, they should have put it way back forward and then sell it. But now it's way past Chinese New Year, Lunar Festival, and it's still not in the web shop. Well, the picture is on the web shop, but it says it's not available. That's a bit dumb. But okay, I don't know what happened there, why it's still not not sold. So let's open this. I don't want to damage the box. I don't like. Oh, where's my X-Acto knife? I want my X-Acto knife. I can't see it. I'll grab the whole thing, the whole jar. Let's see if I can find my X-Acto knife. Oh, there it is. Oh. So, yeah, spring. So I was talking on the stairs. My mom was upstairs and I was downstairs. She already put everything on the stairs for me to just grab. So I said, it's so weird. Everywhere I go, I mean, on Instagram, on YouTube, on digital news, they are talking about today is spring. I'm like, no, tomorrow. That is, I mean, today, 21st of March. Yesterday I was at my mom's, the 20th. So I said, I am a bit sick of it. People telling it's spring, it's spring. Oops, it fell out of camera. I cannot present good. Oh God. God. Okay, like that. Like that. Okay. I have the booklet with instructions. So there were some things that I misgrabbed. I was a bit stupid. There was not on the official LEGO website, on online webshop, but the other one that I love to go, the Play to Go. Okay, not sponsored, but I'm telling you what happened in my experience. I saw this poly bag about a yellow rabbit, and I saw it like 2 months, maybe 3 months. I didn't put it into the cart, and I was a bit dumb. Like the flowers, I was a bit dumb when there was opulent of flowers in LEGO. I didn't buy it, and now by the time it was like Valentine's Day, flowers all gone. That is the mixed flowers, the roses, the tulips. These are three different kinds of flowers that is sold on either the LEGO or the Play to Go. The Play Today, I mean. Sorry, let's open the bag. So a couple of days ago, I went again to the on the LEGO website and on the Play Today website. I believe on the Play Today website, I didn't see it. Did I see it? I don't know. But I saw, on official LEGO website store, that there is this carrot house with the rabbit. That I think it was with the rabbit. I'm not sure. I think it is. And that is, will be sold if you buy things, I mean sets of LEGO, over 60 euros. So that particular yellow rabbit that I want in a poly bag, I misgrabbed it, or I didn't put it in my cart. That's long gone. Never ever you can find it anywhere. But the carrot house, that is new. It's still there, available. So luckily, for spring, I did grab this Brickhead sheep thing. Sheep, sorry. Oops. I mustn't let things fly. So I'm so happy that I ordered this. Why did I do that with my fingers? Okay, let's open. So this is the Brickhead set 40380. So again, sorry, 40380. That's the number for the sheep Brickhead. You get a flower and two mixed colored, multicolored Easter egg. Let's start. So let's see. I grabbed this bingo marker and replace it with my glue bottle so I can point it to the table. Yeah, I'm charging and filming. I'm sorry. Let's see if I can put everything into the scene. Too bad my screen of my cell phone is so small. So we, my mom and I were talking on the stairs, and she said, she explained to me why I was annoyed by people telling, where's the pink one? I need the pink one. That's pink, isn't it? Oh, here, I found it. I found one. It was buried. Okay, I found it. Okay. So I said to her, I'm so annoyed by people telling it's spring today on Saturday the 20th. And she said, no, Minnie, it is spring today to a lot of countries. Because to the Asian calendar, it's a lunar calendar, so it is today spring. So the Western world goes by the solar calendar, and for them it's just tomorrow. So that's why. So I learned new things from my mom. I didn't know that. My mom can explain things way more better than I do. Oh. I think it's because she does for a lot of years she does volunteer work for the Chinese community, especially for the Chinese seniors. Hence why she got in 2019, I'm so proud of her, 2019 she received, well, not out of the hands of our Dutch King Willem-Alexander, she got the pin that you receive. It's a really nice pin. She was ordained by our Dutch mayor of Rotterdam, Abu Taleb. Yes, he's not white. He's not a white man. He is a Moroccan immigrant living, talking, breathing in Rotterdam, and he gave her that pin on her chest. Among how many were there that day? I believe normally by the end of April, there's a special day, and then a lot of people that does a lot of volunteer work for a couple of years, and volunteer work that means you don't get paid. You put all of your hard work and energy, blood, sweat, and tears you put into the job. And just merely to help your community or other people that you don't know. And I've known that she does that for years. And my dad doesn't mind she does that in her spare time. Sometimes he helps her. She asks him, can you come and help me? Because sometimes she can't do things. And she needs my dad's help. But I think she tries to ask him for help so he can does a little bit of volunteer work also, but he doesn't want to call himself volunteer. He doesn't want to be a volunteer, but that's a good, that I think my mom is so smart. That's a good way for him to include into the community. So she did that to me also when I was going to school and I couldn't find a job quickly enough, and I had to go to get, I was quite for a long time unemployed, so I had to get unemployment money. So you don't get it for free, you do need to do volunteer work. So she asked me, can you do volunteer work for us? For us, that means the Chinese community. And at first I said no, but when I saw I was a bit too long unemployed, I said yes. So that's why I got in touch with members of the Chinese community, the seniors, and they all of them put my and my family into their hearts. I have learned a lot from them. I would never say they've learned a lot from me. No, I would never say that. I was so, how do you say it? Honored to do such thing alongside with my mom. My mom has worked hard for her whole life, and when she got ill, she couldn't do that job anymore, being cook at a restaurant, at my father's restaurant. So she had to retire early, not because they had earned a lot of money. No, she works, me and my dad, my family work very hard. And work hard doesn't mean you get a lot of money. No, it means sometimes your health goes. If you don't take care of your body, your health goes way a lot worse than you anticipate. So that's what happened to my mom. She got cancer, different kind of cancer. She had kidney stones and other things. So it was not a fun time for my mom. I remember the first time she called me. I was at school and I went home. She asked my family members to call me to go to this hospital, Dijkzicht Ziekenhuis. It's in Rotterdam, Dijkzicht Ziekenhuis, because she landed in the hospital. She had kidney stones, and she wanted visitors. And she was bored in the hospital. And of course, when you are sick and you don't know how long you need to be in the hospital, you don't know what's happening, if you're gonna die eventually or soon, you don't know. All these things cross your mind. So she asked me to go to the hospital, and I went. And I was in shock the first time. I've always seen my mom. Sorry. I've always seen my mom strong. So this is the first time I saw her that bad. What's this piece? I don't understand this piece. I don't understand it. I have always seen my mom very strong and always full confidence and knowing what to do. What's happening, you know? I don't understand. Oh. What? I did something wrong. And it was heartbreaking for me to see that she was helpless, sick, lying in bed. It was very confrontational. Because all my life, I've always seen my family members working hard, working to their goal. And doing their best. And I have never seen, well, that's a lie. I've seen them sick, you know, normally, influenza, the sniffles, that kind of thing. But I've never seen my family members sick, like cancer or inside the hospital, lying in the bed. I did it wrong. I see a picture here holding this thing, so I'm, oh, this is so bad. Did I do wrong? No, this is good, this is good. I found it. It's a little brush. A little brush. Look at that. In the crafting world, that's an item that we do love. Brush. Put it in here. Okay. So I was really scared, and she asked me how everything is going, because I have not seen her for like 2 days that particular day, time, because she was in the hospital and we were not allowed to see her because she was having a terrible operation to get the kidney stone out. Even it was, she showed it inside a glass container. She showed it like the kidney stones. And even it was this small, like a piece of a kernel, I don't know how to call it, a little piece of sand. That thing was deadly to her. It caused so much pain. So I remember that she asked me things, you know, just to chat for her to pass time. I couldn't talk to her. It was too much. Still, I tried to talk to her because it would be cruel not to talk to her. But it was really hard. I'm sorry. Sorry. So when I was talking to my mom on the stairs, I was so glad that she's okay now. But while talking to her, it dawned on me that she's not okay. Sorry. She's diabetic type 1. I'm type 2. And she said sometimes in the morning, she suddenly wakes up in sweat. So I thought to myself, she can't be have that women sickness we have. When you reach a point like you're 50 or 60 as a woman, you get that women sickness that you sweat a lot. And she's already past 60, so she doesn't have that. But she said it was red in her eyes. She couldn't get up. Getting up get a bit wobbly. So I thought to myself, oh, that's not good. And she said, then she got a little bit to drink. So she pricked herself. We have a machine to prick ourselves so we can see how high the sugar is, how high the sugar level is. And she saw her sugar level was 3.2, and that's not good. That means your sugar is below the line. That means she has to consume something sugary. So she did. She had fruit juice. And but that didn't help her. She recognized. So she ate 2 slices of bread, and that made it a bit better. So sometimes when she tells me these stories, it's just for me. She tells me these stories, real stories, to tell me if in case, Millie, it's a warning. She doesn't tell me much. She just only tell me how she feels and what happened to her. But it's actually a warning for me. In case I happen to have sweaty mornings. And red for your eyes and wobbly on your feet. Then it means your sugar is, of course, I have to measure my sugar first with getting a sample of my blood. And then I have to see how much my sugar is. And then, of course, I have to do these things that she did. But I told her, I have no problems with these things because I always eat bread in the morning. Always. So I don't have these problems. And that's why always my sugar is too high. It's so stupid. My body can eat whatever it wants. Of course, my mouth is like a garbage bin. But my sugar, or my organ that creates the change of when I consume sugar and it changes into something else. When I eat sugar, my body screams high alert, high alert. Even just one little bit, one sugar kernel, or I don't know how to say it. Already my sugar level spikes. So I am very prone to, how to say it, to recognize sugar that I am not allowed to, according my body. My mouth, my heart says eat a lot of sugar as much as you can. But as you know, I am a diabetic. I am not allowed to eat a lot of sugary stuff. So I know how to keep my body healthy, but sometimes my body, especially my heart, screams eat, 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 eat this bar of chocolate, eat this whole bag of candy. And then my head says no, don't do it. So for me, every day is a struggle. And it's about sugar. Sugar is for me like drugs. I want to eat as much candies, cake, as much fruit, all things that have a lot of high containment of sugar. I want to eat that, but I already know I cannot do it. I cannot eat like I used to do in the past when I did not have diabetes. So it's everyday struggle for me. Sometimes when I go really to the letter, it's a Dutch quote or saying, by banning the whole day without sugar, even not eating a piece of fruit, I always feel not good at the end of the day because I have stripped my whole day out of sugar. Not even bread, pasta, potatoes. So, and these are the three things that I love so much, and I can't have enough. I can have a minimal 2 eating spoons of each. So if I have one dinner that contains pasta, I can only have 2 eating spoons. Well, 2 eating spoons, it doesn't make me full, or how do you say, content. The doctor says, yeah, eat just 2 eating spoons that, and the rest is vegetables. So even I eat a whole mountain of vegetables and then 2 eating spoons. It depends what I eat that dinner. It can be pasta or cooked potatoes or fried potatoes or something bready. I am not allowed to eat that. And that is frustrating for someone that is loving food so much. So we talked, my mom and dad talked on the stairs, and he gave me that little package that you saw with the Suriname snack. He said, "I'm sorry, I didn't order a lot, I ordered a little bit. I'm not sure if you want it, if you're not, how do you say it? What's the word? If you are not disgusted, yes. If you're not disgusted by it, then I eat out of the package. I didn't order much of that Suriname sausage because it was something new. Not new for them, my parents, but new for that one of these shop owners suddenly sell these things. That's so weird. A cafe selling Suriname sausages. So that was weird. He said, I'm not sure if you're disgusted by it, that we already ate out of the plastic box. And it's just, you know, the remnants, the remaining bits in the plastic bag. I said, no, it's okay. I'm not disgusted by it. No, I'm not disgusted. It's food. Who in right mind would say no to food? I wouldn't. That sounds really... No. Don't think about it. When I say stuff like that. So... It was fun to see my parents again in living a life. So I was happy to see them. I don't think I know what to do if they're not around anymore. Yeah, I don't think I know what to do if they're not around anymore. My dad was telling stories. He said, "You know your little brother? I am a grown woman. My brother is not little anymore." He says, "You know your little brother? He asked me something." I'm like, "What?" He asked me if I could find Suriname mango. He said, "How the hell can I find Suriname mango? You know, it's pandemic time. You can't get anything shipped out of the foreign country like Suriname into our country, the Netherlands. Because I tried to find like 2 months ago, sopropor. I couldn't find it. But I told my mom I wanted to have sopropor. I love sopropor. When I was young, not so much because it was bitter. And then she said, "Oh, 2 weeks ago, your aunt, Christine, she went to, we have a Suriname grocery store between my house and my mom's house. She said, your aunt went there and she found it, sopropor, but it was this small. I'm looking at her. You can't find sopropor this small. But, you know, I thought by myself, maybe she's exaggerating. She said, my mom said, "You know, your Aunt Christine asked that woman, how much?" She said, "Is it 2 euro? And then she come to me, that means my mom, and she says, "Christine asked me, is it too expensive, 2 euro? And then my mom says, "If you want to eat and you want to spend money, just go buy it. Don't think about if it's expensive or not." Because that's true, what my mom says. I find it hard to... when I was looking for sopropor, it was hard to find it. Because that the sellers when I asked her, she says no, because of the pandemic, shipment is not regular anymore. It's hard to get Sopropo at all. So when I heard that my aunt could find Sopropo that easily, like 2 weeks ago, I would have said buy it, but just buy it. I couldn't find it, so. Well, I don't go regularly to the Suriname supermarket, sorry. I don't go regularly there because Suriname groceries are a bit expensive, so I'd rather pay very little for my groceries, so that's why. Let's see. I'm not sure how much time I still get to do it. It's like already 46 minutes and I'm halfway. Oh, halfway. I need to do fast. So, oh, sorry.